She was never a Madonna. No one ever called her a saint. But you can't go through life blaming and shaming people for what they ain't. 'Cause what she was an honest queen. Not exactly all my young men dream, but when I think of what she could have been, she was an honest queen.
Peter, a lot's happened since the Allen Brothers first trod the boards, as it were, in Sydney. But after your reception at the bitter end in Greenwich Village, do you feel now that you're established as a solo artist, or are you still working on it?
I don't think my goal is really to be established. I'm still working on whatever I'm doing. But I'd say definitely now I'm a solo artist. I don't think I'd work with anyone again.
You're one of the slowly increasing number of Australians who are sort of making it overseas.
Uh-huh.
Was there a single breakthrough for you, or was it just a series of events?
There was a couple of breaks in my personal life that forced certain decisions, you know. It's like to quit what I was doing and to start something else. Then I had some friends that helped me know what I really wanted to do, and they helped me get on my... Because I've been at the bitter end 3 times, and the first time was... I just didn't know what I was doing, but it was terrific just to be there. And the last time I was there because the album had just come out, and so it was terrific.
The occasion we mentioned first was with Helen Reddy.
And the last time I was there, I was with Helen Reddy, yeah. Her album had come out, and she had I Don't Know How to Love Him. And my album came out about a week before, so we thought it'd be nice to be on together. It was nice.
Yeah. Have you become assimilated to New York, or do you have the traditional love-hate relationship with it?
I guess so. I'm lucky I have an apartment that I can escape the street really easily. It's down in the West Village, which is very quiet, and I have a garden out the back, so and a piano there, and I don't need to go out too often. I don't need to hit the streets too often. I can stay there and work.
Peter, your music's a lot quieter than it used to be. Are you a lot quieter than you used to be?
I don't think that... I didn't really write songs when I was here, you know. I just used to sing anything that was popular. And I rarely sing anything now that I didn't write myself, so... I don't know. The album is kind of quiet, but I have the feeling that my next album will have a lot of happier songs in it.
Yeah. Do you ever rock along these days?
This summer I worked at a place in East Hampton, and I was there the whole summer, and it started off the beginning of the summer I was playing very quiet things, but towards the end my friend Joe Butler, who used to be the drummer with a Loving Spoonful, and Steve Boone brought John and Yoko out one night, and there were some wild nights, you know. Yeah. It was fabulous.
Do you ever yearn for the simple times of days gone by when it was, you know, bebop or whatever, and nothing much to worry about?
I really love old rock.
Yeah.
I just adore it, yeah. I think that the audiences now really require more than just someone getting up and singing someone else's song. You know, I think that they like to know more about you, and if you write the song, it's usually a... Well, in one of my songs, I say, if you like who I am now, that's only a reflection of yourself, whatever that means.
Just a little boy way across the sea, I heard a lot of pretty songs at my mother's knee. There was only one place I wanted to be, in Dixie, way down south. I wanted to be a darky making music all the day. Didn't want to be a white folk, 'cause they didn't know how to play. But Australia's a long way away from Dixie, way down south. So I'd sing Mammy and get down on one knee and dream that Alabama was the only place for me. My heart was breaking, 'cause on some distant shore there were folks out eating possum till they couldn't eat no more. But now that I've been down there, I got a big surprise. No magnolias blossomed there before my very eyes. I'd like to know who made up all those goddamn lies.